Hello friends, welcome back to AwelsTech. Well, I'm back again with another video on new boot. This time it is my Windows Server 2012 R2 that failed to boot with error and operating system wasn't found. Try disconnecting any drives that don't contain an operating system. Press Ctrl Alt Delete to restart. Now, if you know the boot process, it is the bootmgr that reads your BCD file to load the winload.exe and then loads the OS. In my case, I believe it is the bootmgr that is missing and that is why I received this error. So it seems that I'll have to recreate a new bootmgr. Okay, so to do this, I will reboot the machine and insert a bootable media. Okay, press any key to boot from CD or DVD. I have used Windows 8 bootable media, but you can use Windows 7, Windows Vista, Windows 2008 R2, any bootable media. Okay, so once you boot your OS in the Windows recovery environment, once you boot the Windows using bootable media, you get this Windows. On the setup screen, click Next and then select Repair your computer. Okay, if you see, I get this pretty good UI. That is because of the bootable media Windows 8.1. If you use Windows Server 2008 R2, the options would be different. Okay, but yes, the major options would still be the same. So click on Troubleshoot, click on Advanced Options, and then click on Command Prompt. On the command window, type C colon to go to the C. So C drive here is my directory, is my drive where the Windows is installed. Okay, now let's confirm if the bootmgr is missing. Okay, so I type attrib-h-a-s. Okay, this command is to ensure that I am able to see all the hidden system files and folders. Okay, I'm pretty sure that the bootmgr is missing, but let's see if it's the same problem. So I type dir, and if you see bootnxt, bootsec, and then initpub, bootmgr is missing. So it seems that I'll have to recreate a new bootmgr. Okay, to do that, run the following command: bcd boot space C colon backslash Windows forward slash S and C colon again, hit enter. Wait for the output. Okay, you see boot files successfully created. Alright, so now let's type the dir again to see if I see the bootmgr or not. Okay, if you see, I don't see the bootmgr. Also, the previous file, that is bootnxt, is missing. Okay, let me type the command attrib-h-a-s and hit enter. And I'll type dir again. Okay, do you see bootmgr is there? So, now that the bootmgr is back, let us simply exit the command prompt and click continue and see what happens. I would not select any key as I do not wish to boot the CD, boot the OS from the bootable media. Alright, it seems Windows is loading. Let's wait for a while. This seems to be promising. Alright, please wait. Okay, so this gives me a confirmation that everything has went smoothly and that the bootmgr is able to find the operating system and my machine will boot successfully. Okay. Alright friend, that is all for this video. I hope you liked it. If yes, please hit like and do subscribe. Once again, thank you very much for watching the video and have a great day ahead. Goodbye.